In the first half, awarded to his side as well, overturned after an on-field VAR review, which did look like the right decision to overturn it.
Richarlison and managed to get just in front of him to take off the power. See, so on that right hand side, Ricardo Angulo coming back to try and help out Jesus Angulo when Anthony was on the ball.
In the final minute of normal time, still we are goalless in this men's Olympic semi-final between two of the most attacking sides in the tournament. But when you come up against a side that also likes to get forward, but is packed with quality, it's not just gung-ho on every occasion, although Mexico's quarter-final against Republic of Korea was pretty gung-ho. That won't be kept in by Ricardo Angulo.
That was a crazy game against South Korea as well. Basically every shot went in. It's one of those games that don't tend to be repeated too often.
There were some shots, weren't they? The majority of the goals, absolutely sublime strikes.
Incredible goals in that game. Can't help but feel this is awful a little bit for bigging up this game, saying there are going to be loads of goals. And here we are at the 91st minute, 0-0.
Never. Richarlison, matched by a brilliant challenge by Jesus Angulo.
That's better for Jesus Angulo. Didn't let Anthony get anywhere near that strong challenge. And another change here for Mexico.
Yes, Alexis Vega's evening is over, and Roberto Alvarado, who has scored once at Tokyo 2020, that was when he came off the bench against Japan. He's not played since, so scant reward for that goal. Can he repeat the feat? Can Brazil find the latest leg winners? Arana. Lana's there for company. Good defending by the youngster. Martinelli tried to flick it to himself almost, but Brazil will continue to come forward. Vital interception by Romo, waiting on the penalty spot. That's it for them in this tournament.
Pinier has had an influence on this game since coming on. Can produce those runs from deep, bursting into the box. Couldn't find a teammate there.
call was the right one. Still goalless. Here is Douglas Luiz of Aston Villa for Brazil. Guimarães. Space for Richarlison. Trying to slide it through to Lanier. Come to Malcolm. Looking for Richarlison. Got away by Montes. Linus has to be careful. Almost stolen off his toes by Arana, but he's done very well there, the 21-year-old. Mexico will try and counter. Dani Alves clearance that time. Doesn't get the distance. Here is Alvarado. Well blocked by Nino. Will fall kindly for Brazil.
Alves, Linus in his purest form, purest essence. So much talent. Perhaps taking the wrong decision in the end, just about getting away with it because of his skill.
Here he is on the ball once more, Diego Linus, the 21-year-old. Swings it in. Some good delivery. Headed over by Henry Martin, and he is getting the chances. That one a half opportunity in truth.
Well, he's had three or four headers now, Henry Martin. I'm not sure he's hit the target with any of them, and someone who is so good in the air, despite not having the greatest height, they've been good balls into the box as well, so he'll be disappointed not to have been able to at least get the headers on target, force the goalkeeper to a save, just maybe for him to be able to build on confidence as well, because having had four headers, they've all gone off target. It's not the ideal situation for a centre-forward.
Double substitution, and you wonder if this is going to be able to continue with that in mind. Our Brazil are appealing here. Dani Alves to Malcolm. Mexico dropping deep but well organised. Here is Guimarães. Proving a very difficult unit for Brazil to break down. Luiz. Guimarães. Taking on Rodriguez, he's done very well there, Guimarães. And yeah, wanted it. Deflection will fall kindly for Ochoa. It's good defending.
Just looking on the touchline. Mexico preparing to bring on Adrian Mora, who is a centre-back. So we suggested that they desperately wouldn't want one of their centre-backs to have to come off. Looks like one of them is going to have to come off.
Here's Eduardo. Aguirre down there as well. Final rolls off the dice for Mexico. Using six of their seven substitutions. Here is one of the players who's come on, Ricardo Angulo. To another, Alvarado. Martin had made the run. That's very well stepped up by Diego Carlos. It was just clipped there by Henry Martin. Good reading of the situation by the Brazilian centre-half. Well, here is the substitution. It's not Vasquez, so it looks as though he will be able to continue after taking that knock. Jesus Angulo is off. Adrian Mora. second substitute appearance at these Olympic Games. Martin making his way over to the touchline. That will be the end of his evening as well. So, birthday boy, Eduardo Aguirre, 23 today. And he has a fabulous record from the bench for Mexico at Tokyo 2020. He's made three substitute appearances. He's scored in two of them against France and the Republic of Korea. Now looking for his magic once again.
The goal he scored against France was absolutely superb as well.
Here come Brazil looking to score a goal of their own. Alana's delivery. Rodriguez wasn't quite sure. Early moments in the Mexico defence, and they deal with that very well because Renier was up there putting on a lot of pressure. Mexico have done superbly there.
Well, the introduction of Mora has necessitated a shift to left back from Vasquez. So Mora's going to play alongside Montes. Montes at centre half. They play together at Monterrey, so they'll have that understanding. They have changed the centre back pairing, shifted Vasquez to left back to make way for Angulo. Now, whether that's because Angulo had an injury or it's tactical, we'll see.
I tell you what, Mexico will hope that Vasquez has run off that knock, because when you switch to fullback, you have the Brazilian attackers put down that right side, although Anthony has gone off, there is still Malcolm to think about now.
Yep.
It's going to be a test. Those are the calls that managers are in the position to make, and Jaime Lozano has decided to make that call.
Basically the only defender on the bench for now, so he's the only option.
Yep, if there was a problem for Angulo. It would have been a limited decision, and again, we see yet another free kick. As Mexico come forward. From Aguirre, too much pressure.
He's not someone who's going to hold the ball up as much as Henry Martin. Aguirre is there perhaps to chase balls over the top. Chase lost causes. He's not someone who can play with his back to goal as well as Henry Martin can.
Richarlison is down here. The substitutes involved early on in the action. Richarlison.
Doing some quick maths, we're on about a free kick every two and a half minutes in this game.
Unfortunately, all the chance of goals, many of them not in places that are dangerous. Just breaks up the rhythm of the game and the flow. As Brazil look to get that rhythm moving once again. Alves. Came through to Martinelli. Mexico will clear, and here goes Diego Lainez. Can he find the end product? It's a great run by Lainez. A shot driven in from Rommel. It's high. Not easy for Santos to watch over.
Well, Ines did really well there, and you could see exactly what he wanted to do when he was breaking forward. He wanted to get into this position so he could take on Bruno Guimarães. Instead, come back, and it's a good Artu Angulo. Couldn't get it in his stride, but dangerous there, Diego Lainez. Those are the kind of attacks that Mexico are going to have in this extra time period, because Brazil are going to come in, players full. So the spaces will open up.
Might they open up here? Aguirre, very well challenged, and Douglas Luiz will send it forward for Brazil. Missed control from Malcolm. Vasquez will keep it in.
Had a season at Barcelona, Malcolm, and it was didn't go according to plan. Only one season. He didn't seem particularly happy. Fans didn't necessarily take to him, but he actually did perhaps a bit better than people might think. Scored four goals. He scored against Real Madrid in a Clásico, the Copa del Rey.
Here is Martinelli of Arsenal. Quick ball in. Ochoa wasn't sure as Arana went for goal.
Had that terrific chance in the first half. Seems a long time ago now.